And just in case you were wondering, yes, we are discovering genes for ADHD. We have had more success in this area of psychiatry than with any other disorder that I know of. We now know from genome scans published just last year, where we've scanned all 35,000 active human genes for ADHD genes, that it's going to be about 20 to 25 sites. And out of those 20 to 25 sites, we've nailed down about 5 to 7 of them. And here's a few. I want you to notice that there's a D in front of the first four genes. It means that those genes regulate dopamine in the brain. So no surprise, the genes that regulate dopamine are ADHD risk genes, and no surprise that drugs that improve dopamine in the brain work for ADHD, because those drugs are altering the effects of these genes in the brain, which means that psychopharmacology is a form of genetic treatment. Isn't that fascinating? It's not a Band-Aid. It's not a cover-up. It's not missing the point. It's actually helping to manage the underlying genetic problems, if you will, the genetic differences in the brain. Now, let me take one of these genes and explain it to you because it's kind of cool. I won't go through all the genes, but bear with me. This is a nerve cell that I pulled out of your frontal lobe. Ouch, I'll bet that hurt. And if you look at this nerve cell, when this little baby gets stimulated, an electrical impulse is going to proceed down this nerve cell. And as that impulse reaches the end of the nerve cell, these little packets of chemicals, dopamine, are going to move toward the outside membrane and burst. And as they burst, they're going to spray dopamine out into that little gap called a synapse. And if there's enough dopamine out there, it's going to cross over and bind to this membrane, and it's going to fire the next nerve cell in line. And that's how your brain works, neuroelectrical impulses. But the point here is that there's dopamine being squirted outside the nerve cell. Now, do you see this little baby right here? That's a vacuum cleaner. And there are many of them on the outside of this nerve cell, because the job of that little pump, the job of that little pump is to vacuum up all the dopamine once it's done its job. And it's known as the reuptake transporter. And one of the genes I showed you, called DAT1, builds and operates that pump. If you have a longer version of that gene, you have too many pumps on your nerve cell, which means when this nerve cell fires, the dopamine gets vacuumed right back up again, and it can't do its job, and it leaves you in a state of too little dopamine. Now, here's the really cool part. People with ADHD have about 30 to 80% more of these vacuum cleaners on their nerve cells in the basal ganglia. And the other cool part is, you want to know what Ritalin does to the brain, or Concerta when you take it? It goes right there, and it plugs up the vacuum cleaner. Like a sock at the end of a vacuum hose, methylphenidate stops the transporter from working. What does that do? Leaves more dopamine outside your nerve cell. Methylphenidate is a dopamine reuptake inhibitor. By the way, Strattera does the same thing, but it does it for norepinephrine, a little bit for dopamine. But nevertheless, we can now link a gene to a problem in the brain, and we can link that problem to a drug. You shouldn't be surprised to find that that gene is a predictor of who is going to respond to methylphenidate, at least in the last three studies that have looked at it, which means that sometime in the future, when you go into an office, we may take some of your saliva, genotype you, and decide which drug to give you, because it's looking like genes will predict your drug response. So I would want families to know that, because that's probably 5 years out, maybe. Maybe more, maybe less.